6 pi electron, and hence it is aromatic. We have 2 plus 2, 4 pi electron, and it is anti-aromatic. This has sp3, so it is non-aromatic, right? This carbon atom is sp3, non-aromatic. It has 2 pi electron. For n is equals to 0, it's true, so it is aromatic. It has 4 pi electron, anti-aromatic. It has 6 pi electron, again aromatic. It has 2 pi electron, aromatic. This carbon atom is sp3 hybridized, non-aromatic. Okay, this has 5 pi electron, odd electron, so it is anti-aromatic, right? Okay, so it is 2 plus 2, 4 pi electron. 4 pi electron means what? It is anti-aromatic. Oh, this is 5 pi electron, odd electron if you have, then non-aromatic, not anti-aromatic. Okay, now you see here, oxygen has 2 lone pair. Out of this, 1 lone pair is involved in resonance and other lone pair is perpendicular to the plane of this ring. Okay, so we'll count only 1 lone pair for the to decide the aromaticity of this compound. Okay, so we have 2, 2, 4, 2, 4, 6, 8. We have 8 pi electrons. And hence it is anti-aromatic. Right. Remember one thing always, if an atom contains two lone pair, then to decide aromaticity, will count only one lone pair. Okay, always remember one thing, this is very important. Okay, we count only one lone pair. So here the oxygen contains two lone pair, we'll count only one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 into 2, 8, 8 pi electron, anti-aromatic. Okay, you see this is one electron which is present perpendicular to this plane, because the one p orbital is available here in lateral overlapping. Okay, so this lone pair is not involved in resonance. You must remember this. Pyridine, the name of the compound is, this lone pair is not involved in resonance. We'll calculate 6 pi electron, and hence it is aromatic. You see, when I say number of pi electrons, we always count the pi electrons or lone pair which are involved in resonance. Okay, that's the thing. So here you see, this lone pair is involved in resonance, so we have 6 pi electrons, aromatic. Out of 2, only 1 is involved, 2 plus 2, 4 pi electron, and hence it is anti-aromatic. You see these examples, we have 2 or 2, 1 is available in the resonance, 2, 4, 6, 6 pi electrons, aromatic. Okay, it is a conjugated system, Wiegand orbital, 4 pi electron, anti-aromatic. 2, 4, 6 pi electron, aromatic. 2, 4, 6 pi electron, aromatic. 2, 4, 6, 8 pi electron, anti-aromatic. Okay, so like this we have discussed many examples. Okay, there are a few more examples left. Okay, so we'll see those examples in the next session, and then there is one more case. How do we decide aromaticity in multiple cyclic molecule? Okay, in which we have more than one cycle present. Okay, and there are a few cases also in which the double bond is present outside the ring. Okay, how do we assign that? Like in this case, like the ring is conjugated and we have double bond outside the ring also. So those kind of examples, some miscellaneous examples, we'll see in the next session, and we'll also see one case where we have multiple cyclic compound and how do we assign aromaticity, non-aromaticity and anti-aromaticity in those molecules. Okay, so we'll see you in the next session. Thank you. Okay, so what is aromaticity? Aromaticity is what? It is the property of property of cyclic planner conjugated system. Cyclic planner conjugated system. Okay, it provides extra stability to the molecule. It provides extra stability to the molecule. Okay, stability because of aromaticity dominates on all other factors. Okay, if the molecule is aromatic, then its stability will be maximum. Okay, that is what you have to keep in mind. And the next thing is what, how do we understand that the molecule is aromatic? Okay, so for that, what we have, like I have written over here, it must be a cyclic system. It must be planar conjugated cyclic planar conjugated system, and it must have 4n plus 2 pi electrons. 4n plus 2 pi electrons, where n is the natural number, can be any value, 0, 1, 2, and so on. Okay, this rule is given by Huckels, one scientist, the name is Huckels, and we call it as Huckels rule. Okay, 4n plus 2 pi electron, Huckels rule. Okay, so for example, you see, the very common example of aromatic compounds, if you take, it is benzene ring. So in benzene ring, you see, all the p orbitals are parallel. And in this also, the molecular orbital forms. So this 6 pi electron, 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6 pi electron are present in pairing in molecular orbital. Right? Present in pairing in molecular orbital. Okay? And because of this only, since there is no unpaired electron, it is highly stable. That's why we say aromatic compounds are highly stable. Okay, now there is one more type of term we have here, that is anti-aromatic. First, we'll discuss all this term and then we'll see examples on this. Okay? Anti-aromatic is what? In short, we'll write aromatic compound as A. Anti-aromatic will represent by A dot A. Right? In this, all conditions are same, like the system must be cyclic, planar, conjugated, number of pi electrons should be 4n pi electrons. This is the only difference here. Cyclic, planar, conjugated is same as aromatic compounds, but the number of pi electron is different, which is 4n pi electron, where n is any natural number. It can have 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay, so if you calculate here, I forgot to tell you one thing. If you calculate the number of pi electrons here, we can say we have 6 pi electrons in the benzene ring, right? And if you cross check with Huckel's rule, we know when n is equals to 1, it gives 6 pi electron. So this number of electron satisfies Huckel's rule for n is equals to 1. It is cyclic, planar, follows Huckel's rule, and hence this compound is aromatic. Okay, so here also the same thing we have, but the only thing it has 4 n pi electron present. Okay, for example, you see, if I take this one, cyclic butadiene, you see it is planar, all carbon atom is sp2 hybridized, cyclic also, conjugated system also there, pi sigma pi, and number of pi electrons if you see here, it is 4, right, which follows this rule, 4 n pi electron, okay, so for n is equals to 1, it follows 4 n pi electron for n is equals to 1. So this 4 pi electron is, in this also, hybrid orbital forms, sorry, molecular orbital forms in this one, and in the molecular orbital, we have 2 unpaired electrons, one is paired and the other 2 is unpaired in the molecular orbital, okay. So in this molecular orbital, because of this 2 unpaired electron, this molecule is highly unstable. Because of 2 unpaired electrons. Okay? Now the third type of compound we have here is non-aromatic. And non-aromatic, in short we write NA. Okay, these compounds are not cyclic, right? If cyclic, then not conjugated, okay, these non-aromatic compounds are actually normal compounds at room temperature. For example, you see, right, these examples are non-aromatic compounds. First of all, this is not cyclic, so non-aromatic. This one is cyclic, but it is not a conjugated system. Conjugated system, when I say, it means it is completely conjugated, right? Like you see here, this carbon atom is sp3 hybridized, okay, and the delocalization of electron from here to here only, this part is not involved in resonance, so this is not a complete conjugated system, okay, because this carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. Any cyclic molecule, if the sp3 hybridized carbon atom is present, it is non-aromatic always, okay. So the point is what, this is the normal compounds at room temperature, this is highly unstable compound, and this is highly stable. So because of aromaticity, it provides high stability to the compound, okay. And then we have non-aromatic compounds, normally at room temperature, and then anti-aromatic compounds. So stability order, if I write down here, this order they have asked many times in the exam, stability order, we have aromatic first, then non-aromatic, and then anti-aromatic. The order of stability is this. Okay, this you must remember, it is very important. Okay, so this is the few examples we have discussed, few like the theory we have discussed for aromaticity, anti-aromaticity and non-aromatic compounds. Okay, now in this session the examples are very important. Okay, so we'll see the examples next. Few examples I'll write down and then we'll discuss. We'll start from the very basic one, benzene ring. Okay guys, welcome back to the CENTUM Academy again. Last class, friends, we have discussed about aromaticity, okay, and we have also seen
few examples of aromaticity. What is aromatic compounds? Okay, how it provides the, you know, extra stability to the molecule. Okay, we have also discussed non-aromaticity and anti-aromatic compounds. Okay, what are the conditions for aromaticity and anti-aromatic compounds and non-aromatic compounds are there, that we have already discussed, and we have also seen few examples based on it. Okay, and like I said in the last session, that in the next session we will also see some miscellaneous examples of aromaticity, and then we will also discuss how do we decide aromaticity in multicyclic compounds. Okay, so now in this session we are going to discuss the some miscellaneous examples of aromaticity, and let's start with this session, right, with this examples of aromaticity. Okay, so first of all I'll just write down here aromaticity. Okay, like I said, that for aromatic compound it must be cyclic planar conjugated system which has 4n plus 2 pi electron. Okay, so we'll see few examples here. Okay, so now we are going to solve these questions. So you see this compound, we call it as furan. Okay, and like I discussed in the last session, that whenever an atoms in the ring contains two lone pair, so only one lone pair is, if it is possible, then involved in resonance. Okay, so out of this two lone pair, one lone pair is involved in resonance. This molecule has 6 pi electron and it is aromatic. Okay, 2, 4, 6 pi electron, aromatic. Similarly, thiophene also has 6 pi electron and aromatic. Okay, now you see this molecule has, this electron is involved in resonance. Okay, this one is not involved in resonance, this lone pair. Okay, so 2, 4, 6, it, this molecule also has 6 pi electron and it is also aromatic compounds. Similarly, it has 1, 2, 3 pi bond, 6 pi electrons, compound is aromatic. Okay, in this one you see resonance is possible because of vacant p orbital, 2 plus 2, 4 pi electron, and this is anti-aromatic. Okay, here you see this molecule, we call it as inorganic benzene. Inorganic benzene, or we also write it as borazole. Inorganic benzene or borazole. You must have seen in the book that they have drawn a coordinate bond here, like this and like this coordinate bond. Why? Because all these boron atoms, you see, they have vacant p orbital. Okay, so this can accept this lone pair of electron from this nitrogen atom. Okay, so we have a coordinate bond from this to this, this to this, and then this to this, inorganic benzene. Okay, so we have 3 pi bonds here, you see, 1, 2, 3 pair of lone pair we have here. So it has 6 pi electron and hence this is also an aromatic compound. Okay, this one you see 2, 4, 6 pi electron, it is aromatic. Okay, this molecule has 8 pi electron and according to that it should be anti aromatic. Okay, it should be anti aromatic, but it is not anti aromatic, but it is non aromatic in nature. Non aromatic in nature. Why? What happens here? See, if the cyclic compounds contain 7 or more atom, okay, then the molecule changes its plane. Okay, so this becomes non planar then. So that's the point we'll write down here. Note down this point. The number of atoms present in the ring is more than or equal to 7, then the molecule change its spleen. Explain and loses conjugation. Loses conjugation, okay. And when conjugation is not there, it cannot be aromatic or anti-aromatic, okay. Hence, in all these cases, whenever the carbon and whenever the ring contains more than or equal to 7 atoms, it must be non-aromatic, okay. So this compound is non-aromatic. Similarly, you see here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 pi electron, but the compound is non-aromatic, okay. 7 atoms are there. Here what happens, 1, 2, 3, 6 pi electrons, molecule is aromatic, okay. Remember, this boron has vacant p orbital, okay, so resonance possible here. Okay. Similarly, here you see this carbon atom has positive charge 2, 4, 6 pi electron, and this is also aromatic in nature. Conjugation is also there. But here you see this carbon atom is sp3, right? So the molecule is what? Non-aromatic. Okay. The molecule is non-aromatic. These are a few examples, important examples of aromaticity we have discussed. Okay. There are also few questions in which the double bond is present outside the ring. Okay, so in that case, what we should do, that we are going to discuss now. I'll write down the few questions and then we'll discuss. Now we'll discuss this. You see here, we have double bond O here. In this case, whenever we have double bond present outside the ring, then we'll try to draw the resonating structure of this. Like the first example, I'm taking this one here. You see, the molecule is this, double bond O, and here we have lone pair. If you draw the resonating structure of this one, okay, so what happens, this lone pair comes over here and this pi electron goes here, right? And we always draw this resonating structure with this double bond which is outside the ring. So the resonating structure here, it is, you see, N double bond, this will be as it is, and here we have O negative, H, N for nitrogen, we have positive, okay. Now you see this molecule has 6 pi electron, and hence it is aromatic. So we'll first draw the resonating structure and then we'll get the idea whether it is aromatic or anti-aromatic. You see here, this molecule has 6 pi electron and hence it is aromatic in nature. Okay. In this also, what we'll do, this lone pair comes over here and this pi electron goes here. Right. So again, in this ring, you see it is 6 pi electron. This is also aromatic. Okay. In this, what happens, this pi bond will shift here. We'll get a positive charge here, right? So 2 pi electron it is. It has 2 pi electron, which is also aromatic in nature. Okay. Again, in the ring, we have 6 pi electron, aromatic in nature. Okay. Ring, you see this, it is 6 pi electron, and hence this is also aromatic. Okay. This has more than 7 atoms present. So this is non-aromatic in nature. However, we can see there is a conjugation and number of pi electron, if you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it has 12 pi electron, right? Non-aromatic in nature, right? According to the rule, if you see, it should be anti-aromatic, 12 pi electron, 7 pi electron. But since the number of carbon atom is more than 7, hence it is non-aromatic, okay? Similarly, you see this molecule has 6 pi electron, aromatic in nature. Again, here if you draw the resonating structure, this will be the resonating structure. So it also has 6 pi electron in the ring, which is aromatic, right? So these are the few examples we have discussed where we have only one cyclic compounds are there. It means only one cycle we have here. So what happens, if you have multi-cycle compounds, means more than one cycle is present in a compound, then how do we assign aromaticity and non-aromaticity or anti-aromaticity? Okay, so next we are going to discuss those examples in which we have multi-cyclic compounds. Okay.